station on Space to Ground.
Nothing like robots and spacewalks to get the new year started. Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. 2017 is starting off with a supercharged upgrade to the station's power system. Since New Year's Eve, ground controllers have been hard at work using the Dexter robot to install new batteries for the station's power system. Lithium ion batteries are replacing old nickel hydrogen batteries and will be used to store electrical energy generated by the station's solar arrays for use while the station is in darkness. So far, they've successfully installed 3 out of 6 new batteries and removed 4 out of 12 of the old. Expedition 50 Commander Shane Kimbrough and Flight Engineer Peggy Whitson spent several hours working in the vacuum of space. They completed their primary task to install adapter plates on the electrical assembly where the batteries reside and relocate several old nickel hydrogen batteries that will no longer be used. They also connected data cables between the new batteries and the adapter plates that allowed ground controllers to do their initial checks on the new cells. This was the 3rd spacewalk for Kimbrough and the 7th for Whitson, who matched Sonny Williams for the most spacewalks by a female astronaut. This week, Rocket Man on Twitter wants to know what the temperature is like inside a suit during a spacewalk. Well, since the suit is essentially a mini spacecraft, the air conditioning comes standard. To stay cool, astronauts wear the liquid cooling and ventilation garment. It's essentially space-age long underwear that has a series of tubes running along the body that carry cold water, allowing the crew members to cool down while hard at work. A temperature-controlled knob is located on the front of the astronaut's suit, which they can raise or lower at will. And as I once found out, it can get hot pretty quick inside any spacesuit. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.